Thank you very much. I would like to thank the organizers for this conference. Greece and Russia have always been good friends. So from Greece into Russia, Orthodox religion has been brought, a lot of Greek words and a lot of other things. So in Greece we like Russian literature, Gogol, Dostoevsky, Tolstoy, Shalyamov, Solzhenitsyn, and music. Serafim Sarovsky, Svetaya Matrona, and others. So thank you very much for this.
Hope that my English would be better than my Russian. I am from Greece and I represent World Organization for Early Childhood Education, and I am really grateful to the president of OMEP Russia, Larissa, and my close friend Natalia Rizova for helping me be in this conference. I am really proud for Greek language, but it is not only because I am coming from Greece, but because many ideas were expressed for first time in my language. So I can understand, for example, what a pedagogue means, or pedagogica, like I see in facultet around. What does it mean? And I would like to ask you for a second to think, what do you think pedagogy is? I would like to think that one thing, that in the roots of the language, pedagogy, there is pedi, which means child. And child means play. Παίζω παιδί. This pe means play. So it is important when we speak for children to think that play is the central thing in that. But is it negative or it's neutral play, or is play has to do with learning? Think what learning means for you. In Greece we say play theater. A theater was a school in Athenian democracy a lot of 100 years ago. We say play music. So play means that I am happy, and I am happy together with someone else. It is very difficult for me to express in my title, there is this changing word. Why our world is changing right now? I am coming from a place where many political issues are around, but also the war in Syria. In my country, 63,000 people have come as refugees in my country, and they have changed somehow our ways of behaving, but for us, these people are neighbors. We do know the Syrian people, and we also have another issue to think about. What other European countries, how other European countries reacted to this issue? We speak so much for human rights, justice, fairness. There are so many treaties and conventions, but when we come to the point, we see that we are not very far from the time when the Second World War stopped and these days we had this celebration here. So if we think all the different stone of this mosaic, we can see, for example, these huge towns in Asia or in other places of the world. We can see the huge inequalities. We are speaking for quality, for standards, and all these things. But are they, could they be practiced in reality? In our place, in our kindergartens, in our schools? What is the political and cultural movement right now all over the world? I am not going to read everything, but I would like to be there because I am going to say only the main point. Platon, who was a very the very first philosopher, and has written a book about how a state should react, says that the very first priority of education should be citizenship. The state should provide the children, the youngest and future citizens of this state, all the things which are necessary to be a citizen. And to be a citizen means to be very critical, to put important questions and fight for the right answers. So this is, for example, democracy is not only for voting, but this cra in democracy has to do with power, where the power is. If we vote, but the power is somewhere else and not in the people, there is no democracy. There is only representative system. And this has to do with our values and with the education of our children. Many years ago, the right to education was confirmed in the Convention of the Right of the Child and in many, many documents later. In 1990, learning begins at birth. And this is very crucial because it has to do with early childhood education. Then, 2005, there was the general comment on the right of the children, and there are, for first time, for preschool education is mentioned as offered for 1 year. So we have Dakar, and we have Millennium Development Goals in 2000, when preschool education was not mentioned. But many organizations, like NAIEC and many others all around the world, UNESCO, UNICEF, we had a lot of we put a lot of effort in order to have early childhood education in at the highest level of the United Nations. This is an important milestone because it was held in Moscow 2010, and it was accepted that countries' wealth in the 21st century is not defined in material terms, but by the quality of their human capital. It puts forward early childhood care and education as a critical first step toward building the wealth of nations. I don't like the rhetorics about wealth and capital and investment, but perhaps this is the only people in power can hurt easily. So perhaps we can use this metaphor, but from my point of view, not as the first priority. The first priority should be always the right of every child or everywhere in the world to have access to the best possible quality early childhood education and care. And then, 2015, at the end, it was adapted at the sustainable developmental goals. There are a lot of arguments about that, about how early childhood education can contribute to development and learning. Everybody knows this Heckman figure, which is very persuasive to the people in power. So, for the first time in our history, we are satisfied, we are happy that in among 17 sustainable developmental goals, there is target 4, speaking about inclusive and equitable quality education and lifelong learning. And in 4.2, we have early childhood education. By 2030, ensure that all girls and boys have access to quality early childhood education, care, and pre-primary education so that they are ready for primary school, for primary education. We are happy for the first part of this goal. We are happy for girls and boys and access and quality early childhood education. We are a little bit concerned about the second part. What actually mean that they are ready for primary education? How this readiness issue is defined? Since the definition has not come out yet, we should raise awareness about how this target would be defined in the future. There are many options, there are many directions, and some of them are child-friendly, but some of them are not very child-friendly. So Stephanie spoke about standards before, and so we should be very concerned how our societies and our governments or our networks will define this ready for school. I think that everybody in the field of early childhood education understand readiness as a multidimensional with a multidimensional perspective, but we are not sure if government will accept this open or they will choose a test-like approach. So we should celebrate the target, but we should continue to fight or to negotiate or to raise public awareness. At the same year, in Incheon, South Korea, there was Education 2030 agenda, and it was the rhetorics were very good. Let's enjoy them. It is inspired by a humanistic vision of education and development based on human rights and dignity, social justice, inclusion, protection, cultural, linguistic and ethnic diversity, and shared responsibility and accountability. We reaffirm that education is a public good, a fundamental human right, and the basis for guaranteeing the realization of other rights. It is essential for peace, tolerance, human fulfillment, and sustainable development. So please keep these words in mind, and whenever you are in a panel discussing how this readiness issue will be practiced, remind that this Incheon Declaration is very important, and it is about human rights, it is about public good, it is about holistic development, it is about diversity, inclusion, and equality. We are concerned, I will be on time, don't worry. There are some words around that makes us to concern about direct testing, outcomes, performance, private sector, schoolifications, schoolification of early childhood, standards. There is a lot of issues around, so we should try to participate in this dialogue and raise the voice we have developed throughout the years. And I think that we, the kindergarten teachers, together with the academia and the organization fighting for early childhood education, can manage to change somehow the route. So Continuing Stephanie's discussion, could be universal criteria, yes or not? And this is about European Union, but there is no time to elaborate on that. There are different kind of that, and we can discuss perhaps later on in the theme. Спасибо большое.